Prince Harry's new book out, Spare. I've listened to some of his interviews, and I'm 3 hours into his listening to him read his own book. It's 15 hours, so I got 12 more hours. But it strikes me, in listening to this very candid portrayal, how much there's an inauthentic self, like a Mooney self, an inauthentic self that has to be the royal, and your own feelings, your own needs, your own desires have to be suppressed. And at one point he's talking about going with his father, the king now, to South Africa, and how there were a group of Brits who were given a great valorous award for killing Zulus who were defending their land. And he just says, you know, what we did was wrong. It was imperialistic. It was colonialistic. You know, what the hell? So I look forward to learning more, but it gave me a window into thinking about, you know, what's it like to grow up in a family where your predecessors, your great grandparents, thought they were chosen by God to rule the world, to send people out and take over countries and destroy indigenous cultures and make them speak English, etc.
I myself was trapped as well. I didn't see
a
way
out. You felt trapped? You were trapped?
Yeah, I didn't see a way out.
But you'd had this life your whole life. This has been your life your whole life.
Yeah, but, you know, I was trapped, but I didn't know I was trapped. But the moment that I met Meg, and then our worlds sort of collided in the most amazing of ways, and then to see how the
race... Please explain how you, Prince Harry, raised in a palace, in a life of privilege, literally a prince, how you were trapped.
Trapped within the system, like the rest of my family are. My father and my brother, they are trapped. They don't get to leave. And I have huge compassion for that.
Well, I came here because I was changed. I'd changed to the point of I'd outgrown my environment. Therefore, this was the most obvious place to come. You know, it's one of the places where I think my mum was probably going to end up living, potentially. You know?
So follow, follow the sun, the direction of the birds, the direction of love.
I often think about, in any relationship, oftentimes, when a guy falls in love with a girl, his buddies are like, oh my God, he changed. I don't see him anymore. He's always with her. And you blame the girl. They're angry with her because she's the thing that took him away. And that's whether you're in a small town or a big city or in the royal family. He wouldn't have ever been attracted to or interested in me if he hadn't already been on his own path.
What you've described here today, being trapped and not even being aware of it, and all the things that had transpired, and then she comes into your life, and then you're doing therapy. Do you think in some way she saved you?
Yeah, without question. There was a bigger purpose. There was other forces at play, I think, throughout this whole process. I'm the last person to think, ooh.
Yeah.
You know? But it's undeniable when these things have happened, where the overlap is. So, yeah, she did, without question, she saved
me. I think that's lovely. I would disagree. I think he saved all of us, right? He ultimately called it and was like, we've got to find a way for us, for Archie. And you made a decision that certainly saved my life. And saved all of us, but you know, you need to want to be saved.